Thanks for tuning into Dirty Teeth and welcome back to the channel. Today we're going to discuss chain lubes, specifically WT-1, which was recently released by Wolftooth Components. Discussing which lube is the best can be a touchy subject, and many cyclists get all riled up defending their particular brand. I've personally been married to my lube of choice, Dumonde Tech, for years and have no reason to stray. I was reluctantly curious to see if WT-1 could live up to the Wolftooth hype. So join me and let's find out if it can actually dethrone Dumonde Tech as my favorite bikepacking chain lube. Carrying different lubes for different occasions isn't practical. We want one lube that can handle everything we throw at it. I've always felt that different lubes for wet or dry conditions is purely marketing hype designed to get you to spend more lube, especially when there are lubes out there that crush it in all environments. Meet the original Dumonde Tech. I know, I've already mentioned it in other videos like the Tour Divide Prep Series. I'm not bashful to reiterate my position that it's been hands down the best bikepacking chain lube. I know you all have your favorites, and I'm sure you'll give me an earful down in the comments. It's all good. Anywho, when I first read the announcement for Wolftooth's WT-1, I was intrigued. On paper, it has many of the same qualities I love about Dumonde Tech. My curiosity peaked even more when I found out that WT-1 was manufactured by SCC Tech. This is a lubricant company a few of my friends have been buzzing about for the last couple of years. So with a few mouse clicks on Amazon and a few months of testing, I'm ready to announce the results of my chain lube throwdown. Before I dig in, let's clear an elephant from the room. Are there any differences between WT-1 and SCC's slick product? I confirmed with both Wolftooth and SCC that the formula used in both products is absolutely identical. The only difference is the color. SCC is a true blue, and WT-1 is more of a greenish hue. It's also worth noting that the Wolftooth version includes a ball bearing in the bottle. Does it help mix the liquid better? I don't know, but it sure has that fun spray paint vibe. Wolftooth also went with the translucent bottle so you can see how much you have left. I prefer this over the opaque bottle from SCC. Otherwise, these products are totally interchangeable. They're even offered in the same sizes, either a 2-ounce bottle or a bikepacking friendly 1/2-ounce size. The retail price is roughly the same for both as well. $19 for the 2-ounce size and $6 to $7 for the 1/2-ounce. Moving on, I'll jump back and forth between WT-1 and Slick, but you can assume that my impressions and the info hold true for both. With that out of the way, let's briefly switch gears and chat about Dumonde Tech. They started making clutch oil for kart racing in 1985, which spawned all kinds of high-end oils and racing lubricants. Their motorcycle and bicycle chain lubes have been in production for well over 20 years. Industry 9, a high-end hub manufacturer, specs Dumonde Tech free hub oil and grease in their products. Suffice it to say, Dumonde Tech has a pedigree in this arena. Their chain lube is offered in either regular or dry, blue or yellow. Again, I feel the options are marketing hype. The formula is the same in both, but the blue is more concentrated, making it better in extreme conditions. To me, it's a no-brainer to go with blue since bikepacking inevitably brings the extremes. And yes, I've used the yellow plenty, but I honestly can't tell the difference except I have to reapply it more often. So yeah, back to the blue. It's somewhat transparent, kind of the hue of Windex. It has a distinct smell that I quite enjoy, but not everyone does. Kind of like nail polish, maybe? It's made of liquid plastic that adheres to chain surfaces. It's extremely potent and designed to be used sparingly. Dab a small drop on each roller, wipe away the excess, and you're done. It's safe on plastic, rubber, and seals, so it's safe to use on cables and pivot points as well. Before applying Dumonde Tech for the first time, you should degrease and dry your chain. I'm pretty lazy to do this with new chains, but it's worth it. Just shove it in a Ziploc bag with some solvent or degreaser, pull it out, dry it off, and let it hang for a bit. After that, it takes about 3 applications for maximum bonding to occur. As you ride, dirt gets pulled to the surface of the chain. So every time you wipe it down, you'll get more and more grit out, and the chain becomes quieter and cleaner. Very satisfying. It doesn't get washed away by water either. The best part is you only need to reapply when your chain starts getting noisy. Even if it's dirty or mucky, as long as it's quiet, you're still good. It's proven worthy to me time and again over countless thousands of bikepacking miles in every condition imaginable. It also works great for winter fat biking or commuting in extreme cold temps. Enough said. Now let's talk about SCC. The small company is based in Salt Lake City, Utah, and was co-founded by Kevin Van Loon and Len Waldron. Fun fact, SCC stands for Silent, Clean, Cool, which is how all drivetrains should run, right? The current slick treatment was released in 2018, so it's still pretty young in a bike industry that's saturated with various lubes, no pun intended. For those of us that already have a favorite, it's pretty hard to validate trying something new, especially at $19 a bottle. I get it. Anywho, the formula is composed of 4 main ingredients. A synthetic lubricant, a penetrant that reaches into micro crevices, a detergent that floats grime to the surface, and a dispersant which prevents the grime from recontaminating the chain. In layman's terms, it lubes, cleans, and protects your chain at the same time. Boom. They say you'll feel the magic in 3 rides. More on that in a minute. Application is pretty much the same as Dumonde. Add a drop to each roller, wait a few minutes for it to seep in, then wipe away the excess. Reapplication is recommended every 25 hours of riding or when you hear performance diminishing. They have testimonials claiming a whopping 4,000 to 6,000 miles of use on 1 2-ounce bottle. If you're not familiar with Wolftooth, they're Minnesota based and chain rings and other drivetrain products are their bread and butter. So partnering with SCC to offer a chain lube was a logical addition to their line. I tested WT-1 over a couple of months on multiple bikes in various conditions. Everything from pavement to gravel to single track. Dusty, dry, rainy, muddy, swampy marshes, creek crossings, you name it. Here's the lowdown. The viscosity of WT-1 hits the sweet spot. It's not too thin or watery, so it doesn't drip off the chain and make a mess. On the other hand, it's not too thick or gloppy, so it doesn't attract dirt and it's easy to wipe away. It comes out of the bottle with minimal effort while applying it to the rollers. The green hue is just as easy to see as the blue of SCC Slick as it's seeping into the chain. The odor is faint, much less potent than Dumonde Tech. I've applied it in cramped pit toilets, hotel rooms, and my own house. It's nice that it doesn't stink up the joint. You don't need to prep with a solvent or degreaser when applying for the first time or fitting a new chain. Just have at it. I purchased a 2-ounce bottle for testing, but the half ounce size should prove fantastic to take along bikepacking. Honestly, it's lived up to all the claims made by Wolftooth and SCC. Much like Dumonde, it definitely cleans while lubricating. This is evident by all the dirt and grime that continues to come to the surface days after applying it. After multiple days of rain and mud and sand getting kicked up into the chain, it still remains quiet without feeling crunchy. I just wipe it down every day and the chain stays shiny and clean. If conditions get really nasty, I'll use a chain brush before wiping it down. Other than that, I'll just re-lube every 2 to 3 days while bikepacking, which is usually before the chain starts making noise. At home when I'm doing normal rides for a few hours, I can usually get 6 to 7 days before I start feeling guilty and lube it up. So basically, I found their 25-hour reapplication recommendation to be spot on. My chains are happy with WT-1, and if you can't tell yet, I'm 100% sold on it. Is it better than Dumonde Tech? Tough question. Full disclosure, I'm not sponsored by either, I paid full price and there's no underlying allegiance. Their performance is pretty much on par, but WT-1 lasts a little longer between applications, especially as conditions diminish. It's almost double the price though. In extremely cold temps, including snow and ice, Dumonde Tech thickens up in the bottle a little, but still performs flawlessly. I haven't had a chance to use WT-1 in the winter yet. It surprises me to say this, but assuming WT-1 performs as well as Dumonde in the winter, I'll have to cautiously give it the nod. That said, you can't go wrong with either. And I'm especially happy to support SCC as well. They're the smallest of the three companies and they meticulously developed a fantastic product. So even though I enjoy shaking the ball bearing in WT-1 and I love the toxic fumes of Dumonde Tech, the next time I need some chain lube, I'm inclined to buy SCC Slick, which shouldn't be necessary for a good long while. Thanks for hanging out till the end. I hope this video gives you some food for thought next time you're in the market for some chain lube. I'm curious, what chain lubes do you love the most? Let me know down below. If you enjoyed this at all, please give us a like. I upload fresh mountain biking and bikepacking content every week, so please consider subscribing to the channel and tapping the notification bell. Until next time, ride bikes, give back, pay it forward.
Thanks so much for squeezing dirty teeth into your busy schedule. Please help us reach more people and ensure you receive new videos by giving this video a like, subscribing to the channel, and clicking the notification bell. Until next time, ride bikes, give back, pay it forward.